When it comes to aerial combat, both in short or beyond visual range, air-to-air missiles play a vital role. A cat-and-mouse game is going on between these missiles and targeted aircraft in terms of technology. Combat aircraft deploy a range of measures that include electronic jamming, dispersing chaffs and flares, as well as high-G evasive maneuvers to get an incoming missile off its back. A new approach to increase the probability of a successful hit in air-to-air combat is being investigated by the U.S. Air Force. The concept involves employing an air-to-air missile equipped with a flexible nose that can maneuver to intercept the target before it evades the attack. At the 2023 Air and Space Forces Association's Warfare Symposium held in Aurora, Colorado, the missile utility transformation via articulated nose technology, MUTANT project, was presented by the Air Force Research Laboratory, or AFRL. AFRL is the main scientific research and development center for the Department of the Air Force. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how MUTANT will change aerial combat. Let's get into the details. In the case of a conventional air-to-air missile, a change in the target's movement beyond the calculated intercept point necessitates a complete alteration of the missile's trajectory. AFRL notes, a more effective missile tends to have more range, maneuverability, G capability, and agility, airframe responsiveness with limited weight. The missile control actuation systems, CASs, affects all three of these metrics and, hence, the ability to effectively close in on targets. Each CAS or CAS combinations, such as dual canards and fins, have distinct and strong implications to overall missile performance. CAS is good for range, fins only, tend to be bad for maneuvering and agility. CAS is good for maneuverability and agility. Canards, wings, jets, thrust vectoring tend to be bad for range due to drag or additional weight. To mitigate these drawbacks, MUTANT has been conceptualized. AFRL argues, however, with MUTANT, the approach is to utilize the physical movement of the missile's front section to correct its course and align it more accurately with the actual location of the target, thereby eliminating the need for extensive course adjustments. AFRL states that it aims to significantly increase missile range and lethality against highly maneuverable targets with a better flight control actuation system. The MUTANT program's approach is a form of active morphing involving high-rate pivoting and the missile forebody, referred to as articulation. AFRL states, U.S. weapons technology advancement primarily involves fixed, outer mold line, or OML, geometries that reflect a design compromise over the various stages of weapon delivery, like launch, boost, cruise, terminal homing, endgame. For example, what is aerodynamically good for range is not good for maneuverability. Morphing weapons technology allows continuous OML change to tailor performance to each phase of flight. Historically, size, weight, and power of morphing technology has been prohibitive to a missile system level benefit. MUTANT is in the midst of tipping the scale in the morphing weapon's favor. AFRL notes, missile articulation is not a new concept. The open patent and technical literature contains reports on articulation going back to the 1950s. AFRL advances the ACAS knowledge base and technology readiness in considering integration and function at the missile system level. AFRL further notes, articulation is accomplished with an articulation control actuation system, ACAS, comprised of a composite high-strain skin structure that envelops an internal electromagnetic actuation system. With a single articulated joint, the missile forebody is used as a flight control surface to augment air-to-air axis symmetric missile effectiveness. With 6 years of basic and applied research investment, AFRL understands how to design, fabricate, integrate and employ the ACAS to improve missile performance. AFRL advances ACAS technology readiness through laboratory and ground test events. From mid-fiscal year 2023 to the end of 2024, AFRL will perform 3 ground tests, culminating in dual articulation and fin control in maneuvering a modified Hellfire missile. The Hellfire is used for research purposes and is not necessarily the intended application of the ACAS. AFRL notes the features of F-35 Joint Strike Fighter in this context. It explains, "Many articulation ideas are outlined in patent literature, but they're not all plausible for supersonic missile environments. One promising approach involves rotating segments with canted interfaces. In concept, the action is similar to the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter vertical takeoff and landing swivel nozzle. AFRL developed an electronically controlled actuation system comprised of compact electromagnetic motors, bearings, gears, and structures. Careful design allows a circular pass-through for component wiring into the aircraft body. A composite skin structure protects the actuation components from the environment while maintaining a smooth outer mold line, OML. A homogeneous material may be the most practical for the skin, but engineering requirements led to a composite structure involving a metallic internal skeleton that is infilled with an elastomer. The combination of these materials, along with special designs of the skeleton topology, allows smooth bending while still carrying a portion of the loads." AFRL also states that 3 skin concepts have been developed to various technology readiness levels. The United States military is confronting a future in which there are progressively more agile and dynamic aerial threats, such as sophisticated combat aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, and missiles. Unmanned platforms, which are not constrained by the physical restrictions of human pilots, will have the ability to perform exceedingly extreme maneuvers, potentially rendering current missile systems less efficient against them. The Air Force Research Laboratory emphasizes that advancements such as this are considered crucial to achieving the Air Force's wider vision for aerial combat in the future, especially in the context of NGAD, which is essentially a 6th-generation platform. It notes, "Next-generation air dominance, NGAD, requires broad advancement in manned and unmanned aircraft, their family of weapon systems, and the communications between them. Medium and long-range air-launched missiles are a key component of tactical air dominance and resilient basing, USAF Operational Imperatives 4 and 5. ACAS technology is directed at fulfilling future. NGAD requirements through the intercept of highly maneuverable targets or threats at longer range with limited cost. It will certainly be interesting to see how the MUTANT project progresses, since it could be a game changer."
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.